Do you think it's been long enough that Tony's come down? Should I let her come back? I kill Tony.
First day of school! First day of school! First day of school!
No, never mind. Potato. Where'd you come from?
Tiffany, today's the first day of school!
Yeah?
Yeah, today's the first day of school. I can't wait to go to class and meet all my new friends and make all of my lessons learned.
Okay.
That sounded weird. They're probably gonna fail me on English already. Which is sad, because that's what I went to college for. Oh, look at this. It's kind of like the outside, but on the inside. Is he okay?
I think so.
Oh, I love this. Look at the
amount of
glass.
Detail. Like, this looks very realistic. Why is the water green? Look at the water.
The water's green?
Is that, yeah.
I think there's moss on the rocks.
Okay, maybe? Yeah, that's why.
Oh, is that like a crest or something? It looks like there used to be something there, but it got taken off. Either that or someone hawked a really big loogie right there.
I suppose some introductions are in order.
Oh my god, look at all of our new friends!
Must be different, starting Hogwarts in your fifth year.
It is different.
Everyone's talking about you.
Everyone's talking about me.
It's like, who's the new girl? Who's the new girl?
Hi, what you reading? Is that a good book?
Can I help you?
That seemed a little rude.
I know, right?
You're the new fifth year. I'm Sebastian Sallow. Welcome to Slytherin.
He all of a sudden changed again.
Ministry escorts to school.
He was a friend of Professor Figgs who merely joined us for the ride.
Still, impressive. Dreadful way to go, poor fellow. Glad you and Fig are all right.
He decided to be nice to me after he realized I'm interesting.
It was exciting.
It was dreadful, certainly, but quite an experience nonetheless.
Interesting perspective. How did you and Fig manage to escape?
It's all still a bit of a blur, to be honest.
Didn't mean to
magic.
Press. You just get
it's
yourself settled. We can talk more later.
What are you reading?
What book were you reading?
A spell book I picked up. Has a few interesting things, but not exactly what I was looking for. I'm sure you'll find out soon enough. But not every spell you may need can be found in our assigned textbooks.
Oh, so we need to do extracurricular reading? More books!
Are you saying some spells aren't taught at Hogwarts? Which ones?
Seems I may have met a kindred spirit. That is a conversation for another time. It was good meeting you. Good luck today.
You got secrets, boy.
He does. I kind of wonder what kind of spell was he looking for.
Just look around all these things. I like all the things they have around. Like, ooh. I don't know what that is.
What does this do?
I might want to think that again.
Ooh, it spins! I hope I don't get in trouble for, like, messing with their crap. Like,
why are you touching that?
It moved.
It moved? Who's playing?
That is so cool.
Who's playing this game? Does the game get bored and play with itself, like in Toy Story? Uh-oh.
That was a quick game.
Yeah, that was pretty quick.
What is that?
Bird?
The graphics look really good, like how realistic everything looks.
Oh, yeah.
Are we inside?
Oh, yeah, we're underwater.
We are?
Yeah, so the Slytherin common room, it goes underneath of the lake.
Oh,
so we can see fishies and stuff. It's like having a giant aquarium right there.
Oh, that's cool. Oh, look at the fish over there. I hope those windows are, you know.
Sturdy?
Yeah.
Should we find out? Oh, I scared the fish! Oops.
Oh, what's this?
Oh, God! Oh, no. Oh, no. No, no.
I don't want to think that again.
Clearly. Okay, who are you talking to over here?
Ugh, not going to move there, are you?
Here, watch this.
Don't say I didn't warn you.
Checkmate.
Told you. You should have listened to me.
Ah, I know who you are. You're the new Slytherin, the one who barged in with Professor Fig last night.
Really?
Interesting tactic on your first day, taking all the attention away from the first years. I'm Imelda, by the way. Shame I wasn't with you and Fig. I could have lured that dragon away. My skills on a broom are legendary.
Oh, excuse me.
She seems kind of full of herself.
Yeah, she does. We've had a handle.
We had it. We got it.
Mm-hmm.
We handled it. And I think you're underestimating the nature of a dragon. A broom would have been kindling.
Burn.
Not the way I fly.
Uh-huh.
Perhaps
sure.
One of these days I'll show you a thing or two about flying. I can teach you more than Kagawa ever could. Speaking of which, I'd like to get in some time on my broom before classes.
Are you a keen wizard chess fan? You knew that boy was going to lose the match.
Not really. Much too sedate a pastime for me. Also, it's simply not that challenging. The moves are always so obvious. Why does no one else see it?
So she seems to think a lot of her flying. Do you fly a lot?
Do you have a lot of time to fly during school?
I make the time. There's nothing like swerving through the spires of the castle and around the Quidditch pitch to clear the mind.
I guess on that we can agree. I can't wait to go flying.
That's what I would do if I was
totally
just fly around, whatever, you know.
To heck with homework, man. I'm just gonna fly around the castle, check out the sights.
Goodbye, Imelda.
Nice meeting you.
Sure.
Sort of, anyway.
Yeah, everybody here seems to have like a little bit of an attitude, but I guess it's Slytherin, so.
Yeah, I mean, you get a bunch of ambitious people in the same spot and they're all like trying to push themselves, so
yeah.
It comes with a bit of sass.
I think I heard one.
Heard one what?
Doubt mermaids find us that interesting. Ah, based on all the chatter when you entered the common room, I'm guessing you're the new fifth year. I'm Ominous. Ominous Gaunt.
Nice to meet you, Ominous.
Well, you certainly had a memorable arrival.
I think he's blind, because he's not looking at us. That's kind of cool.
Okay. I'd do like to make an entrance, maybe.
Well, if I'm going to make my mark here, I had to start right away.
You're definitely in the right house.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Know if I can be
yeah,
of any
I don't think he's looking at us.
First days here, though I doubt you'll need it.
Were you expecting to be sorted into Slytherin?
Most certainly. My family on my father's side are direct descendants of Salazar Slytherin, one of the four founders of Hogwarts.
Oh, wow.
Not something I'm especially proud of, mind you. He was obsessed with blood status, a pure-blood maniac. Unfortunately, most of his descendants do not fall far from that tree.
Can you imagine how embarrassing it would be, like, if you're descended from Slytherin, though, and then you ended up, like, I don't know, in Hufflepuff?
Did that student say he thought he heard a mermaid?
Yes, but I've never heard of a mermaid showing up outside our common room window. It is fun to play along, though. Been known to keep some first years on the lookout for hours.
Oh, wow.
You're so mean. You gotta mess with the new people.
Thank you, Ominous. Very nice to meet you.
Pleasure was all mine. Don't be a stranger.
So, talking about messing with
is
people.
Is the new fifth year Slytherin in here?
No.
Professor Weasley's waiting for you just by the stairs.
Okay.
Cool.
I'll go there after I tell my story. So, talking about messing with people, I used to work at a pizza place. And every time we had a new person, and we taught them how to stretch pizza, you know, you're stretching the pizza dough. If the pizza dough ripped, we used to tell them you have to call the other store to get the dough repair kit. Because we didn't have it, we let the other store borrow it. Every store that was owned by that franchisee or whatever knew this joke. So the new person will call a store and say, hey, I need the dough repair kit. And the person in the store, on the other store, would say, oh, I don't have it, this other store have it, call them. So we had this person calling from store to store, asking for the dough repair kit, until finally someone would tell the new person, there's no such thing.
And how many people have you called by the time you figure that out?
You know, they usually get to like the second or third store.
And then they're like, sorry, bro, someone's messing with you.
Yep. Is that a trash can talking to that person over there? Oh, it stopped, but.
Was the trash can talking?
I don't know. Oh, the painting is.
The painting moved.
It's like, shh.
Nobody's talk about the trash can, okay?
Oh, can we play the piano?
I guess the piano plays itself, okay. Ooh, it looks like that dragon is licking his butt. I'm not judging, man, I'm just saying.
I'm telling you, like, this place is beautiful.
Good morning. I trust you're ready for your first day at Hogwarts.
I've been dreaming of this day for a long time. Yeah. Can't believe I'm here.
Well, you are here. Make the most of it. You only have one first day at Hogwarts. Now, in light of your unique situation, joining us as a fifth year, you'll need to catch up with your classmates and not fall behind. Especially as you'll be expected to complete your OWLs at the end of the year.
OWLs? Owls?
Yes, your ordinary wizarding level exams. They will determine what type of career you can have when you leave here. After much discussion with the headmaster and the Department of Magical Education at the Ministry, we've devised something extraordinary to ensure your success. Here you are.
A book? A magic book? Wait, where is my book going?
Okay.
What is it?
It is a wizard's field guide. It will help you to keep track of what you are learning so that you master all that's expected of a fifth year. You would be wise to take full advantage of this exceptionally valuable resource.
I just shoved it in my armpit?
Thank you, Professor, but what do you mean it will keep track of what I'm learning?
That is cool. I wouldn't have to carry a backpack.
I know, right?
We'll answer any questions you may have. Walk with me and we shall put it to the test.
And it wouldn't be nearly as heavy if you could just shove stuff in your armpit and carry it that way? And it just kind of disappeared into a little bit.
Okay.
I certainly would have appreciated something like the field guide when I was a student. Using the guide will also train you to be alert to your surroundings.
Okay. Yeah. Will it? Considering that everything moves.
The guide will give you opportunities to practice your magic and educate yourself about wizarding lore.
Okay.
Do keep up.
I'm coming. I'm coming.
Hey, don't try me, lady. I can run.
Why don't you cast Revelio on that statue and see what details the field guide can provide.
Okay.
So this is like a training session.
Ooh! Pokemon cards.
Really? Pokemon cards?
I mean, I guess if you want to be specific, they're like wizarding cards like you get in your chocolate frogs, but...
Do those treasures chests have anything?
Keep your eyes open for more opportunities.
Oh,
has an eye.
Oh, shit! I'm coming!
So you can't walk away from her?
I guess not right now. We'll have to explore more later.
Whoa! What is...
That's the common room.
Oh.
So it kind of
Oh, that's
hides.
Right. Okay, yeah, yeah, that's right. We went through that last time. I already forgot. It caught me by surprise.
It's been a while.
You can get almost anywhere in the castle quickly from Central Hall.
Oh, that's cool.
Why are there books flying around?
Always something happening here. It's the heart of the
Hive.
Oh
my god, this is so
our
cool.
Our King's Cross Station, so to speak.
Look at this place.
Oh, it's a unicorn!
Look at the dragon up there.
Oh, that should be all for now. You'll be expected to attend both Charms and Defense Against the Dark Arts classes today.
Ooh.
And I'd like to be sure you get to Hogsmead as soon as possible to replace the supplies you lost on the way here.
Oh, that's right. We probably lost all our shit when the dragon attacked us.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, what am I going to learn in Charms class?
What will I learn in Charms class?
Exactly what you might expect. Spells, charms, jinxes, all terribly useful. I think you will enjoy Professor Ronan. He's a clever and entertaining wizard, and a talented teacher.
Okay.
Okay, and Defense Against the Dark Arts, what's that going to be like?
Can you tell me more about the Defense Against the Dark Arts class?
Defense Against the Dark Arts, as the name implies, focuses on how to defend oneself against the evils that lurk beyond these walls. A mastery of defense against the dark arts is required for those who aspire to become aurors. Fortunately, we are lucky to have the ever-gifted Professor Hecate in charge of our students' education in that regard.
Okay, and Hogsmead. I know what Hogsmead is. I can't wait to go to Hogsmead.
You mentioned Hogsmead, Professor.
Hogsmead is the only all-wizarding village in Britain and is home to an array of shops and pubs. You should be able to find all of the school supplies you require in Hogsmead.
Okay.
You will also, I imagine, enjoy many a butterbeer there with friends in due course.
Butterbeer is awesome.
Thank you, Professor Weasley.
It reminds me when I went to Universal.
Yeah.
Much to learn. Happily, your professors have agreed to create additional assignments for you outside of class. You'll be up to speed in no time. Judging by your adept use of Revelio earlier, I'd say Professor Fig succeeded in at least showing you the basics.
Yep, yep.
He did, Professor.
He's been terribly vague as to the events preceding your arrival, specifically about what happened after that awful dragon attack.
Yeah.
My suspicion is that there's more to the story than a search for belongings and an extended trip up to the castle.
I mean, yeah, but we're not supposed to tell you that. I'm sorry.
There isn't.
I'm sorry, Professor, but I'm afraid that's all there is to it.
Almost precisely what Professor Fig said.
It's almost like we conspired.
Speak of the devil.
Yep, there
Professor
he is.
Professor Fig, your ears must have been burning.
Oh?
Yes. You seem to have provided our new fifth year with a solid foundation in the basics of spellcasting.
Ah, I'm afraid I can't take all the credit there, Professor. They've a rare aptitude for magic, it seems.
Yeah.
Well, I'm just glad you both arrived in one piece. Perfectly good boats and carriages to Hogwarts, and you chose to fly in the path of a dragon.
I wouldn't say I chose the dragon's path, Professor. Although, unfortunately, it would seem that it chose us.
Very well. Enough chit-chat. I need to get to class myself. Might I rely on you,
Professor? Trying to dig in and get information.
Field guide's map.
She's like, what have you been up to, dude? I want to know.
Yeah, like something's not right here.
Good luck today. And remember to use your field guide. It will be invaluable to you. And invaluable to me, as I'll be using it to keep up to date on your progress.
Yes, Professor.
Come and find me in my classroom after you've attended both classes today, and I'll explain more about those assignments I mentioned. And we'll see if we can't get you to Hogsmead for those supplies.
Hogsmead!
It's good to see you, Professor.
And you. I was hoping our paths would cross today, before you immersed yourself in studies. Did I hear you masterfully evade Professor Weasley's interrogation regarding our late arrival?
Totally.
You did, sir.
I did my best, but I'm fairly certain she suspects we're not being entirely forthcoming.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, well, Professor Weasley is a brilliant and astute witch. It was right to keep the details to yourself for now. We don't know where this path we've embarked upon will lead. It may require a bit more flexibility with your time than she would approve of.
We might have
and
to do sneaky shit.
And she may feel obliged to share details with the headmaster that would be better left between us.
Understood, Professor.
Okay.
Good. Now, as capable as you are, I believe the ability you possess obliges you to be well-trained. Happily, you have the benefit of an exceptionally skilled team of witches and wizards to guide you. Speaking of guides, and so that I may avoid another not-so-subtle reproof from Professor Weasley, why don't I show you the clever enchantment we included in the field guide's map? Unfold it and have a look. The map is enchanted to help you find your way.
This will be incredibly helpful. Thank you.
Okay.
Now, sounds like you've quite a day ahead, what with classes and a trip to Hogsmead for supplies, including your own wand.
A wand?
You'll enjoy Mr. Ollivander.
We'll get a
He's
wand.
An exceptional craftsman and a good friend. I shall reach out when I have more information about our mysterious locket.
But
for now,
okay.
Focus on your classes and pay attention. More than your owls may hinge on the magic you are able to master within these walls.
But isn't Ollivander's in the other place? Diagon Alley? Cast
All right,
charm.
Look at the dragon in the wall.
Dragon?
To look at this. Yeah.
Oh shit! Oh cool! Oh wow, look at that!
I just love that everything moves, you know?
That's wicked!
Oh, just like a flying letter paper. Just randomly. Oh.
Okay. Oh!
What was that?
My book pooped out a fairy for me to follow. Oh, that way. Oh no! The poop fairy exploded.
it went this way. Okay.
I'm just enjoying this place. Like, what was that?
What was that?
Get away from me!
What? 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 What?
Let us keep our heads about
this. Is she trying to
kill him? She's trying to kill him!
Like, aren't they dead?
Boy, she must have really pissed him off!
Ooh, class.
Class time, class time!
Here. Behind you. There is an open seat here.
Oh, thank you.
Thanks.
Hello, I am Nettie. So you are the new student. Have you met Professor Ronan yet?
No.
Shall we begin? Welcome to year 5 of charms. Now, this will be a crucial year in your education on the art of charm work, but I am confident that we will take hold with the passion and rigor requisite of such a challenge. Right, now, everyone, please open your textbooks to page 517. But before we begin, can anyone here tell me the difference between the incantations of the color change and growth charms? Anyone? Anyone? I am afraid it is too late to study now. My, the summer months must have really taken a toll on you all. By the looks of it, you all spent your holidays practicing Obliviate on one another. Do you even remember how to perform a basic summoning charm?
Nope. Nope.
Well, I'm glad we're not the only one.
Well, it seems that we are in dire need of review. Everyone get into pairs and take positions on opposite sides of the classroom. Now let's put those textbooks to use as the blunt objects you so believe they are, and take turns summoning them out of one another's hands. Only one book will be needed per partnership, Miss Dale. Thank you. Get into place now.
Those are really big books. Okay, oh. Do I remember how to do this? Okay. Woo!
Back here. That is not bad.
You are a swift learner. I see a lot of potential, but remember, potential is nothing without practice. Keep at it. You might just rival Miss Onai here. Very good, everyone. That's enough of that. Well, as you all seem
that's
to have
it.
The basics down...
What if somebody hits themselves in the face with a book?
Yeah, that's probably what I would do.
Like, Akio.
Outside for a spot of fresh air. After me.
We're going outside?
Okay, this is a very fast-paced class, I see.
I never had a class this fast. When I went to school, they always took like an hour.
I've always found that fun goes hand in hand with mastery, as I'm sure the Quidditch players amongst us would agree, So, what better than a bit of sport to put our prowess with the summoning charm to the test?
Sport?
Right?
Are we gonna play Quidditch? What are you thinking, bro?
Oh,
what?
Crap.
Well, that's not Quidditch.
I want to learn that skill.
So
that's
why
fast.
Don't we have our newest
that would have taken me a month and a half.
He's hilarious. I hear Alexa talking.
Simply,
Alexa is talking
Accio
to herself.
On one of the spheres and relinquish your charm at the last possible moment. Now, think of this like gobstones, if you will. But instead of throwing the marbles out, you are summoning them toward you.
Okay.
Splendid!
Oh shit!
Happens to the best of us.
Okay.
You're supposed to leave it.
I let go!
Not to worry.
I let go! Oh wait, I have to let go of the trigger. Okay. Okay. I got it now. I know what I'm doing. Okay.
Excellent control there.
Was it though?
Your composure.
Very good. Points to Slytherin.
Okay. How did it come to I get points for that? That was sad.
Some friendly competition. Miss Onai, would you care to give our new student a bit of a challenge?
I don't think I need any more of a challenge. I think I'm good with my level of bad.
You'll be the blues, just as before, and Miss Onai, you are playing red. Clear?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
No. What am I doing? Okay.
Pulling the blue balls.
Okay.
Here we go.
Okay. Okay. I want this ball. Okay. Wait, no, I want this ball. Okay.
Not exactly your typical lesson, is it? Not that I mind.
Oh, okay.
Splendid. Oh, it counts! Yep. It counts!
Oh,
she is way too good at this game. This isn't fair. Like, she knows what she's doing and shit.
Yep.
Oh, stop, 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 stop!
Brilliant.
Oh! Oh! Both of them by like a hair. Oh.
Yes.
Oh, shit. Okay.
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 A little faster than the first one, but slower than the last one. Does that help?
Oh, shit!
Let's do the best of us.
Wait, do you lose points?
Yes.
Oh.
I knocked over one of my balls.
Oh my god. What if you knock one of her balls? Does she lose points or you lose points?
Oh, okay. A bit more interesting, shall we?
Wait, what? No, no! Dude! No!
I think we are well past interesting at this point.
Good luck.
I'll say.
Enough chatter. Focus now. You will need it. This round settles it all.
What's this?
She's already two ahead. I don't think, even if I win.
Okay.
There we go.
Okay, I'm gonna knock your ball out. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna knock your ball out.
Ooh!
Stay focused.
That wasn't my plan. That wasn't my plan at all.
Peace out.
If I tickle her, will it distract her? Shit. There's no way I'm winning this. Okay.
Ooh, there you go. But
stop.
Very good.
Okay.
Here we go.
Oh, if you knock my ball, man.
Oof. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, there's no way you'll pass her point until, because, you know, you lost the whole ball.
Unless I can knock her ball off.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna try it. Okay.
I know everyone here, but try not to be nervous.
Oh,
you're
shit.
Doing quite well. Do not be discouraged.
I am discouraged, though.
Wow.
This is not my sport.
Very good, both of you. Well done.
No, it wasn't. One of us did vastly worse than the other.
It's okay. You can be Process good at many other things.
Gather your things on the way out.
Well done back there. You took the loss in stride. Didn't want to go too easy on you. Took me weeks to become proficient with Akio. Took weeks for me to get anything right when I transferred here. It gets easier, I promise.
Well, good to know. No,
that makes me feel better.
Okay.
That's good to hear. It's a lot to take in all at once.
To put it lightly, I remember how I felt when I first arrived. I transferred here from Wagadu just before my fourth year.
Wagadu?
My mother received an offer to teach divination here. Before I knew it, we had left Uganda and were halfway around the world at a new school in a new country.
Yeah, that's hard.
That is so cool! So there's different wizarding schools in different countries. I guess we knew that from, like, the Goblet of Fire stuff, where they did, they had the Drumstrong and the, Bobaton, I think, was the other one. Mm-hmm. I don't think they ever talked about Wagadu. What's Wagadu like?
Is Wagadu much bigger than Hogwarts?
Wagadu School of Magic is the largest wizarding school in the world.
Ooh.
So, yes. Bigger than Hogwarts. But it never seemed intimidating or overwhelming to me. It always felt like home.
Aww. What's it like?
Is Wagadu a castle like Hogwarts?
Its address is Mountains of the Moon. It is not so much a castle as a beautiful edifice carved out of the mountainside.
Oh, I would love to see it.
I remember the first time I saw it, the mist was so thick I could hardly make out anything at all.
Oh,
and
wow.
Then it just materialized before me, this enormous school that seemed to be floating in midair.
Aw, that is so cool. Awesome. Do they teach magic the same way?
This may seem an odd question, but is magic the same there as it is here?
Mostly, yes. But I did have to learn how to use a wand when I arrived here. Hardly anyone at Wagadu uses one.
Oh, really? Okay.
You can cast spells without a wand.
Oh, yes. I find wandless magic to be much more instinctive. Not to mention quite convenient if one is without their wand. I must admit, however, that I am growing quite fond of using a wand. It seems very dramatic.
It does.
It's nice to learn about another wizarding school.
Thank you for asking. I do miss Wagadu, but I am glad to be here at Hogwarts. Ah, I think Professor Ronan wants to talk to you. Better not keep him waiting. Until next time.
Aww.
Okay. Bye, new friend!
Of course, you can use Accio on humans.
She's not Slytherin, so she's nice.
So
well, you'd be using it on clothing, to be precise, Sebastian. You know it won't work on humans.
What?
Huh?
So you can Accio people, but you'd only be using it on their clothes?
Oh, I
that's
have an idea.
Interesting.
Never mind.
Maybe later.
You wanted to speak with me, Professor?
I did. I trust your first charms lesson lived up to expectation?
Exceeded them.
Well, an outdoor competition wasn't exactly the lesson I was expecting, sir.
What charm is there in the expected? Miss Onai is a talented witch. Take it in stride. One often gains the most from the battles one has lost.
Good advice.
Of course, Professor. It was a challenging match.
Miss Onai is always a fierce competitor, though I sense that she is a bit distracted of late.
Why?
Now, Professor Weasley has asked that your professors give you instruction outside of the ordinary curriculum. Expect to hear from me soon regarding a special assignment that I am preparing for you.
Oh, good!
Okay.
More homework! Yay!
So, talking about moving to a whole different country in a new school. So, when I moved to Florida, I didn't speak English. So, the first day of school was probably one of the worst days I've ever had at school. Because...
Hello there. You're the new student, aren't you?
Yes, but we'll talk later.
Yeah, we'll talk later. We're in the middle of a story, okay?
Yeah, so in the morning, I take the bus and go to school. And the a few days before, we have gone and done a tour through school. And, you know, they show me where the classroom is and everything. Anyways, I was scared. I didn't speak English. I went to the bus. I'm like, okay, so when I get to the school, I'm gonna go straight to class, right? Because we went there a few days before. I knew exactly where my classroom was. When we got there a few days before, we went through the front of the school. Well, the bus arrived through the back of the school. So when I went in, the school looked completely different than when I went there the first time. And the buildings were all like identical to each other. So I was lost. Like I couldn't find
where I can't find where I'm going either.
Yeah, I see that. I couldn't find where my classroom was.
Yeah, the bell rang. Exact problem I'm having.
The bell rang. And I was just like you, walking around.
Where the fuck am I supposed to go?
Everybody went to class and I was the only student walking around, and I didn't have a fairy that pooped out of my book that I could follow.
You should have had a fairy that pooped out of your book. It would solve a lot of your problems.
So I started crying, and then the principal says, what's going on? And I just had this letter that my mom wrote for me that says, I don't speak English, that I might, you know, need help or whatever. Luckily, like, the principal spoke Spanish, and she's like, oh, okay, I'll take you to your class. So she took me to the class. And of course I was late, so I made an entrance just like we did at the beginning of the game where we just barged in late, you know, so everyone's like looking at me and I'm like, oh my god.
Hello.
And I do not want to be the center of attention, you know.
You're so shy and quiet most of the time. Must have been horrible.
Yeah, that wasn't even the end of it.
Oh no, it wasn't?
At the end of the day, the bus number was different, so I missed the bus and I couldn't go. I had to call my mom crying because I missed the bus. It was a terrible first day.
Oh my god. Oh, what about you? Have you ever had to change schools? Or what was the first day of school that you remember? I don't remember much about my school. Like, I changed elementary schools, but it was like between third and fourth grade. So it wasn't that bad, and it was nothing like what you had to go through.
Yeah, this was, it was eighth grade where I started. So it was like the beginning of middle school.
Off on another adventure, this happened. Are we?
Yes. Oh, is that the door?
Yeah. Oh, there we go. Okay, we found it.
Those eyes are looking at you.
They're creepy. I don't like them.
Stupefy.
Are they calling each other stupid? Because that's totally what high school fights are like.
Oh! Oh no!
Professor Hecate!
Perhaps you'd be good enough to blast each other to pieces on your own time. I get new students every year, but I only have one Hebridean black skull. It was a token from the great poacher raid of 1878. No doubt you've heard of it.
No, but that's cool.
You may be asking yourself how an old woman like me single-handedly took out the largest poacher ring in eastern Wales and lived to boast about it. Knowledge.
Okay, I want that.
To the wise, age matters very little. Today we will review a spell that has saved me from death at the hands of dark wizards more times than I care to remember. Levioso.
Levioso?
Levioso?
A levitation charm.
Levioso! A surprised opponent is a weak opponent. Care to defend yourself, Master Pruitt? No? One thing I've learned as an unspeakable is the value of simplicity, especially in the heat of battle. Now, let's practice what we've just learned, starting with something small.
Okay. I like his classes.
They're nice and simple.
Yeah.
And fun. And the professors, like, have a way of putting people in their place if they need it.
Yep.
Levioso.
Oh, I floated a feather.
Now, let's try something a little larger.
A dummy.
I want to be able to move shit with a stick. That would be awesome.
Let us begin with a basic cast. See how the dummy deflected your cast?
Yep, I see that.
This time, cast Levioso first, then the basic cast. Remember,
you kicked that dummy's ass.
Very good, but the best way to practice is by dueling. We'll start with you two. Duelist, take your marks.
Time for a proper Hogwarts welcome.
Now, I want a fair duel, using only Levioso, basic cast, and Protego. You may begin.
I don't want to fight him, though. He knows more than me. That's not fair.
Okay.
This should be easy.
Stupid Protego. Levioso.
Okay, Sting. Lucky.
Nothing else here, though.
Whoops! Oh! Oops! He got me! Let me get down! Oh shit!
Now perceptive.
Let's just say I'm a quick learner.
Not bad.
It's funny that his tone never changed.
Yeah, his tone never changed. Just like oh, just
not
normal.
Not bad as he's spinning in the air. Not bad, you know. It's like his tone never changed. He's rotating in the air.
And you rose to the challenge. Points to Slytherin.
Yay!
Thank you, Professor Hecate. Glad to have the opportunity to practice.
If what I've seen today is any indication, we can expect great things from you. I demand excellence from my students. They are capable of achieving it, and they must achieve it.
That seems like a threat.
A classroom duel is one thing, but battling dark wizards, or as ever more likely, goblins, is a different kettle of Grindelows entirely.
Understood, Professor.
Yep.
So, I'd advise you to keep practicing whenever you can. Perhaps Mr. Sallow will have some ideas for you. Again, well done today. I shall reach out soon with additional assignments.
Sounds good.
All right, that's enough spectacle for one day. Class is dismissed.
Hey, are you okay?
Nice
Even
work.
Though I kicked your ass?
I enjoyed that.
That duel was quite something. Everyone will be talking about it.
It was certainly good practice.
Practice? Felt more like I was dueling an expert.
Yeah.
Didn't expect a new student to be so deft with a wand. Then again, perhaps this wasn't your first duel.
I mean, it wasn't, I guess, because we fought some things before, but, yeah, I'll admit that.
I've dueled enough. Consider yourself lucky I held back.
Yeah.
Huh. Fair enough. You owe me an honest duel when you aren't. You know, you might be a perfect fit for a certain exclusive, unsanctioned dueling organization.
Huh? Ooh, Fight Club?
Exclusive and unsanctioned. Count me in.
Excellent. Knew I was right about you. If you want to get the most out of your time at Hogwarts, you're going to need to break the rules now and then.
Yep.
Whether it's joining a secret dueling club or sneaking into the restricted section of the library.
This is a restricted section.
You just
section?
Have to be clever enough not to get
What's
caught.
In the restriction section? Is it
I'll
dirty?
Keep that in mind.
Good. Pleasure chatting with you. I'm sure I'll see you soon. Perhaps somewhere unsanctioned? We'll see if your performance today was sheer luck or actual skill.
Oh, it's actual skill.
Look for Luke and Brattleby near the clock tower entrance, if you're interested. Till next time.
Okay.
So I guess let's go see about that Fight Club thing. Oh, wait. Oh, no. Let's go talk to Professor Weasley and go to Hogsmead and get our wand. I want to go to Hogsmead.
Okay.
Where is that at? Do we have to follow our pooping book to get there?
Probably.
Yeah, it looks that way. Okay. All right, let's go.
That's a good thing that you have that because there's, even though you have a map, like it's hard to know, okay, which floor do I go down to?
Yeah.
Where do I turn to get there? Like it doesn't seem like it's simple.
Oh, kitty! Perfect. Oh my god. Oh, I love you. Oh, can I make you fly? Can I make you fly? Should I do it?
Do it.
Let me fly.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings. Come back. I need to apologize. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, kitty. I won't do that again. I'm sorry. Oh, poor thing!
my god. Okay. All right. What are we doing? This way. Sorry, there was a cat. Everything had to stop.
Hello?
Can I help you? Oh, it turned into a bird. The plant changed itself. That's interesting. Okay.
Oh, well there. Okay.
What about the room, Professor?
I was thinking the same thing, Deke. Perhaps you could help.
Oh, excuse, Deke.
Bye.
There you are.
Here I am. We go to Hogsmead?
It's a picture of a cat behind where they moved.
They did, Professor.
I heard as much from Professors Hecate and Ronan. Seems Professor Fig taught you quite a bit.
Yep.
Before you arrived.
He did.
I'd wager there's a good deal more to your travels here than what you've told me.
Oh my god, you really want to know,
you're really persistent.
Yeah.
No, Professor!
Nothing more, Professor.
I see. Like trying to get a sonnet from a streeler. Regardless,
is that
you
hard?
Must continue to build upon what you've learned. In that regard, I've asked your professors to help hasten your progress with some extra assignments.
Yay!
Professor Ronan did mention something about that.
In fact, Professor Ronan will meet you outside momentarily to assign your first one.
Oh, really?
Now, okay. Regarding the trip to Hogsmead I mentioned earlier.
Yeah, Hogsmead!
We've arranged to replace the supplies lost on your way here, including seeds, potion recipes, and spellcrafts.
Thank you, Professor.
And Mr. Ollivander will connect you with the perfect wand. You've managed your classes well with a borrowed wand, but you'll find the magic you cast with your own wand to be far superior.
Yeah.
Okay, what's a spellcraft, though?
I've never heard of a spellcraft.
Do we get
before,
to make
Professor?
Our own spells?
What is it?
A spellcraft is a recipe of sorts used when conjuring objects.
Oh.
I shall explain more about them when you begin working with transfiguration magic.
Okay, cool.
There's an Ollivander's in Hogsmead.
There is. Most people are familiar with the shop in Diagon Alley.
I thought it was in Diagon Alley.
We're fortunate to have someone like him nearby. Mr. Ollivander is a genuine craftsman and highly skilled wand maker.
Yeah.
I would trust no one else to pair me with a wand.
Okay, and then what's the deal with the potion shop?
Can you tell me more about the potion shop, Professor?
J. Pippin's Potions stocks a wide array of potions ingredients, although they rarely sell recipes. Professor Sharp asked that they have a couple of particular recipes on hand for you.
Okay, cool. Let's go!
I'm eager to get to Hogsmead.
Very well. I'd like you to make your first visit to the village with a classmate. Help you get your bearings. Perhaps Sebastian Sallow or Natsai Oni. I've noticed you spending time with them.
I think the girl we got along with better.
Okay.
The guy, yeah. I'm not sure about yet.
Okay.
I'd like to go with Natty.
Excellent choice. Miss Oni is one of our most talented students. And she knows the area.
Okay, good.
She'll keep
good.
You well clear of any of Victor Rookwood's undesirables en route.
Mm-hmm.
Rookwood?
Okay. A rather unsavory local. Best to avoid him and his associates, including his right hand of sorts, Theophilus Harlow, if you can.
Okay.
Once you've finished Professor Ronan's assignment, your friend will meet you at the castle doors. No time to waste. The sooner you complete your work, the sooner you can enjoy a butterbeer at the Three Broomsticks.
Yeah!
Okay.
Butterbeer.
Are you? Playing with birds, dude?
Ah, there you are.
You have a new spell to teach me, Professor?
Indeed I do, and an exceedingly useful one at that. The mending charm, Reparo. Fixes Reparo. Things right up, makes a broken object good as new in the blink of an eye.
Oh, that's useful.
It seems as if that might come in handy.
I want
More
that
frequently
spell.
Than one
I
would
know,
imagine.
Right?
As Professor Weasley mentioned, I am not the only one who will be teaching you spells outside of class in an effort to catch you up with your peers. A number of your professors have agreed to do so as well, but first, each shall ask that you complete a few preliminary tasks to hone your magic. I have arranged some for today. See them through and then report back to me. We will have you casting Reparo in no time.
Okay.
Okay, I guess I will do the tasks. I'm guessing this is some kind of Mr. Miyagi shit.
I'll start on the task right away, Professor.
Okay.
Oh, wait. Is this a thing? Revelio. Ooh, I got another Pokemon card! Okay,
This is the right area. I wonder where the flying page is.
Wait, come back.
Right.
Got it!
Oh. So we have to collect those?
Yes!
Okay.
I'm guessing they're instructions or maybe a recipe for potato soup. I'm not sure which.
A flying page must be around here somewhere.
I gotcha!
Brilliant!
All right.
You're fast with that one.
He thought that he was gonna pull one over on me. I was gonna have to chase him, and I'm like, no, bro, guess what?
I trust the preliminary task.
I completed the assignments, Professor.
Marvelous. You clearly know your way around basic charms.
I figured out the Accio.
Let us give the old mending charm a try then, shall we?
Yeah.
Remember to be deliberate in your enunciation and movements. I want to see some vigor. Now, wand at the ready.
Yes, sir.
Remember, your wand is a conduit of your magic.
Okay. Okay, conduit. Do you know how much faster it would have been to repair that bathroom if we had this?
Oh my god. Normally it takes me like weeks to repair something. You can do it in a blink of an eye. I mean, okay. It depends on what it is, of course, but... Like, see? Like that? Like,
that's cool. Yeah.
To repair a whole bridge? You see that?
I want to do that!
Oh, that was just the spell that he did at the beginning with that one bridge.
Oh, yeah.
Have a go with that broken statue in the alcove by the water. It allegedly symbolized heartbreak. Perhaps a jilted lover thought it too accurate and lashed out.
Okay. Oops. It's already broken. I don't need to break it more. There we go.
Nicely done. Works like a charm.
Ooh.
Ooh. Okay, let me see what it looks like. Okay.
I don't know if that's what I would consider the face of a jilted lover. It looks more like someone that just saw Lady D transform into the into that thing.
Oh, hey!
Hi, friend!
Hello. Meet again.
Looking for me?
Yes! Let's go!
Natty, I hope I haven't kept you waiting long.
Not at all. Professor Weasley tells me that you need to go to Hogsmead.
Yes.
You must be eager to have your own things again.
Yes.
And to see the village.
I've been looking forward to it.
Good. Shall we set off?
Yes.
I intend to give you a first-rate Hogsmead experience.
Woo! VIP, 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 VIP. Oh, there's a kite. This is so pretty.
I was glad Professor Weasley asked me to accompany you.
Really?
Aw.
Yes.
That's nice.
I had planned to extend an invitation to you myself. I thought Aww. You might enjoy a butterbeer in the village.
Aw.
The timing of Professor Weasley's owl was perfect.
She's so nice.
Yeah.
Oh, I cannot tell you how nice it is to breathe fresh air after being cooped up in ancient rooms. Grave mistake to take it as an elective class, believe me.
I believe you.
Though I suppose you would not really call it elective when your mother was the one who elected that you take it.
Yeah.
There's like a thing watering the plants by itself.
Hogsmead is beautiful this time of year. Everyone would tell you to visit at Christmas. But that's one of the few times of year I would rather be.
Oh, there it is.
Yep, see it.
That is
not
so
much
cool.
For the cold, are you?
Oh, I do not mind the cold so much. But it has taken some getting used to. I did not grow up around snow.
Yeah,
me neither. Well, we still don't have snow, but it's, you know, like the cold is definitely something I had to get used to.
I often spot lacewing flies in this area.
Oh, what's so special about them?
They are interesting to look at. But if you stew them, you can also use them in potion making.
What in the world?
The daisies honk.
This is beautiful.
I could just walk up and down this road.
Look, yeah.
From the forbidden forest. Hippogriffs. I wonder if something startled them. Huh. I heard rumors hippogriffs had been spotted nearby.
Huh.
Aww. Do you think Poppy's already seen the hippogriffs?
Absolutely.
Likely already named them, too.
Who's Poppy?
And Sugarfoot.
That'll be cool, like, you know, to
that's
stay there.
That's the forbidden forest on the left. It's off limits.
Because they don't only just go to school, but they pretty much live there throughout the year.
Why is it off limits?
Yeah.
The professors claim it is too dangerous. I think that calling it forbidden only makes it more alluring.
Yes.
Yeah, definitely.
There's Hogsmead over the crest, past that ruin.
I wonder what that used to be.
I would spend all of my time exploring if I could.
Ooh, what's
this? I confess, I was surprised when Professor Weasley mentioned that you knew the area, since you're relatively new here.
She said that?
Oh, Thestrals!
Than I had thought.
Oh, look at how pretty they are!
Well, I certainly learn a great deal in class. Much can be gleaned outside of the castle walls.
Yeah, she kind of knows everything, or tries to at least, because she's been trying to... you know, find out what the hell happened with our trip.
Yeah.
How are you settling in? I remember the weeks that followed my arrival feeling quite strange.
Yeah, I bet.
Everything was so new and unfamiliar.
Accurate.
I'm getting used to things. What about you? Do you finally feel settled?
I still miss my homeland, but it is beautiful here too. And getting out of the castle and exploring helped me to adjust quite a bit. Hogwarts has become something of a home now, I would say. Hopefully it will for you too.
Aww.
Yeah.
Mr. Moon! He is the Hogwarts caretaker. Looks a bit worse for wear.
You okay, dude?
Hello, Mr. Moon. Have you met our new fifth year?
Pleasure. You might want to turn back, Miss and I. Turn and run.
Are you drunk?
Is everything all right, sir?
Oh, it looked right at me. Eyes big as saucers.
What did?
What did, Mr. Moon?
Jemmy, guys. Ugly and airy and terrifying. I shall be at the castle where it's safe. Good luck to both of you.
Oh, shit. Are we gonna have to fight something?
A demi, guys. I think he had too much fun in the village.
I think he drank
I have never seen
a little
him in
much.
Such a state.
He seemed drunk.
Yeah.
He seemed very drunk.
There is much to see outside of the castle walls, not just Hogsmead. I am happy to explore whenever you'd like. Rumors being what they are about goblins and such, it might be nice to have a friend with you.
Yeah.
I'll keep that in mind, Natty. Thank you.
She's so nice. I like her. Oh, excuse me, sir.
Excuse me. Didn't mean to bump into you there.
Right there. Look at this. Look at this place.
And
wow.
It is hard to know where to start.
Yeah.
The Three Broomsticks is the place for butterbeer. And you can get any sweet you can imagine at Honey Duke's. I could not choose a favorite shop here. It changes with every visit. I can tell you that you are certain to find everything you need in Hogsmead.
Oh, it's so pretty.
So, when we go to Universal, it is always so full of people, you can barely, like, walk around.
Professor,
it's so nice to see this place, like, just empty, you know?
Yes.
Spellcraft, some seats, and...
a new wand.
Of course. You will enjoy Mr. Ollivander, and I am keen to see what you will do with a wand of your own. You should be able to collect everything you need and still have time to explore a little as well.
Okay,
experience Hogsmead at your own pace. We can meet up in the town circle when you are finished.
Alrighty.
Okay.
Enjoy yourself. I will see you soon.
So, I just realized we weren't actually recording the game. So, after I got really excited about going shopping, we came here and we met this dude, Mr. Brown, and Mr. Brown is selling us some stuff. And I frankly already forgot what he said. What is he selling us?
I don't know, something that we can brew our own, like, I think potions or magic. And then you started talking about brewing Biscuits.
Biscuits. I want to brew biscuits. How would you do that? Like, you know, you get the flour in the cauldron and maybe the butter and the salt, and then it just kind of goes bling, bling, bling. Instant biscuit.
You were talking about whiskey.
Whiskey would be good too.
Yes, and
whiskey
beer.
And biscuits. Oh, and beer.
Yeah.
Yeah, whiskey and biscuits and beer. Anyway.
And then I reminded her that, you know, in the game, we are a minor, so we can't brew any of that. She got disappointed. And then...
Yeah. And then we realized we weren't recording. So all of that is like...
Oh, anyways, this is the first shop, luckily, so...
So you haven't missed much. Okay. Are we recording now, though? Okay, yes. We are recording now. Yeah. Okay, small potion spellcraft, okay. And potting table, okay.
If you're interested, feel free to take a look around at the rest of my inventory.
I can't afford anything. I have like $0. I have $81. And all of your shit is like more than $81, so.
Wow, yeah.
So like I'll come back later.
1,500.
Huh. Okay.
Okay, I'm gonna have to get a job.
Yeah. I wonder what kind of job we can get as a miner. Like, do they have wizardry Burger Kings or something?
Okay, look at this bookshelf. Wait. I want to look at this bookshelf.
Oh, it's crooked. This is cool. I mean, it is crooked, yeah. Whoa, what was that? Did you see that?
Revelio.
Oh.
Yeah.
Found it. Enchanted staircase Pokemon card.
Is that a trend? Wait. Ooh, there's something behind there?
I wonder if it's inside or outside, though.
Wait, I still want to look at the crooked shelf.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Do you want to build me a crooked bookcase? Because no. I'd rather if it was straighter.
This would bother me. Like, if I...
Yeah, this bothers me.
I mean, the ones we have are smiling, you know, because they're not
that's
like...
That's because
they're
got the cheap really...
one. Yeah, yeah, the cheap one. So, like, the weight of the books is like, it's just making it zag. So the bookshelves look like they're smiling.
Got him.
Okay. We can go see what's behind here.
Okay. Ooh, it's over here. Oh, it's a book. Can I read this book? What?
Whoa.
Oh, that's cool.
That is really cool. Okay, look at the picture. Ooh. Wait. Look at the fireplace, where the fireplace is.
The fireplace? Okay.
There's a kitty. There's a picture of a cat. You see it?
Oh, there's the cat. Oh my gosh, this looks like my mom's cat. My mom's cat's name is Callie, and she looks kind of like that.
Aw, it's so cute.
She doesn't like me. She loves my brother, though.
Oh, talking about fireplace, that fireplace right there reminds me of a picture of a kitchen that I just saw, because I design kitchens and stuff, and I saw this picture of a kitchen that has a crooked fireplace through it, and it bothered me so much.
Oh no.
And like, yeah, this kitchen won like I don't know, like kitchen of the month or whatever, and when I saw it, I mean, it's a beautiful kitchen, don't get me wrong, but it had a crooked ass fireplace through it, and it just bothered me so much. I'm like, oh my god, I could not like live looking at the damn crooked fireplace.
And this is why Tiffany is in charge of all our interior design, because I probably never would have even noticed it. This is cool. Huh, self-checking out library books? That's interesting. Look at that. Okay, it takes a card and it stamps the date, and then it puts it in the library card pocket, and then the book goes away.
Okay, cool.
That is awesome. They don't really use those cards anymore. Like, I haven't seen those when I've gone to the libraries.
Welcome to J. Pippin's Potions.
Hi, Pippin!
Pardon me, sir.
Oh, thank goodness. Hmm? When I heard the bell, I thought you were Miss Lawang. Not that she deigns to come here.
Who's she?
Though I don't believe I've seen your face here before.
Oh, I'm new. Either.
It's my first time in Hogsmead, actually.
Is it really? Well, Parry Pippin at your service. And this is J. Pippin's Potions. Potions for all ailments. You'll have read it on the sign, of course, but Grandfather always made me say it in full. How
I hear that, bro.
Today?
Professor Weasley sent me to collect some recipes. I'm new at Hogwarts.
You're the student she sent the owl about. I set your things aside immediately. I suspected if you're anything like I was at your age, you'd want your potion supplies.
Yes.
Is it not the most fascinating art, potion making?
Yes.
Rivals anything you can do with a wand, I've always said.
Yes.
Are potions really that versatile?
They may not be as showy as spellwork, but make no mistake, they are just as powerful. They can heal, destroy, protect.
Make you drunk.
You'll discover all of this soon enough. As it's your first time in, I should mention that it's not just potion recipes I sell. I also offer ready-made drafts for all manner of uses.
Oh!
And I unveil new ones from time to time. Hmm. Pop in when you can so you don't miss out on anything.
Okay,
but
cool.
For now, let's get you those recipes, shall we?
Yeah, okay. Is one of them
what
for whiskey?
What can I do for you today?
Nope. Not old enough.
Edris potion. Okay. What's an Edris potion? Wiganwild potion?
Feel free to take a look at the rest of my inventory. Or come back another time if you're in
spider
a rush today.
Spider fangs? Stench of the dead. How exactly do you collect the smell of dead people? I would like to know.
Ugh.
Okay. What else do we gotta do? It's sparkly, whatever it is.
Aren't those the same, like, little flies you
found
earlier?
Oh, yeah, maybe they are.
Hello there.
Hello. Oh, hello, my dude. What's up?
Pardon me, sir. I'm here for the seeds Professor Weasley arranged for me to collect.
Oh, seeds!
Oh, the Dittany for the new fifth year. I take it that's you, then. Merlin's beard. Starting Hogwarts is a fifth year. You must be positively reeling from it all.
Yeah, it's
not
a lot.
At all. I'm choosing to see it all as one big adventure.
Well, bravo. Not everyone has the temperament to take things as they come. Name's Timothy Teasdale, by the way. And this is my shop, the Magic Neep. I keep the cart out here because I like a good chat. Can't very well be in the thick of things if I'm hidden away inside now, can I?
I suppose not.
In addition to seeds, I have plenty of plants. Grow everything myself. My speciality is potion ingredients. Even Pippin purchases from me.
Oh, so you're the guy behind the guy.
Get you a packet of Dittany seeds. Let me guess. You're after something fresh.
So, my folks want to start selling produce and stuff like this.
Mm-hmm.
And if my dad grew a beard,
this is what he will look like.
Possibly, although my dad honestly looks exactly like Mike Pence. Like, he's been mistaken for the man. He looks identical.
Do have a look around. Plenty of ingredients to pique your interest, I'd wager.
Nothing I could afford.
Yeah, no. We are broke.
Yep, we need to get a job.
Do-do-do. Oh, Accio! Got it.
Nice.
I think I'm starting to get the hangle?
Hangle? You get in the hangle, got it.
I'm getting the hangle of the Accio spell. I mean, I was not very good in class earlier, but I think the extra practice has done me a lot of good. I think I'm good at it now.
Merlin, blooming.
What happened, dude? It's just a customer, nothing bad yet. Oh, the bell rung itself.
I'll be right with. Ah, it's you. Just a moment, please.
He has his wand behind his ear.
Hello, sir. I'm looking for...
For a new wand, yes. It's about time.
Yes, I... About time.
Well, you're our new fifth-year student, are you not? Oh, what am I saying? Of course you are. Gerbold Ollivander's the name.
Mm-hmm.
But of course, you'll have heard of the Ollivanders, I'm sure.
Yeah!
Finest wand makers in the world. It's a pleasure to meet you, truly. Now, come with me. Let's find you the perfect wand, shall we?
I like how he treats us like a celebrity, even though we're just some kid.
You. Yes.
Oh, it's green.
Yes. Hmm. Powerful core. 10.5 inches. You might do. Here, give this one a try. Well, go ahead, swish.
What? What?
How odd. Once more, come on, really swish it.
out here.
That seems dangerous.
Well, this isn't a good match at all, is it?
I don't think so.
No.
No.
We'll find you something, not to worry.
No, not you.
So how does he decide this?
Perhaps.
Yes. I think it's kind of like when you go to a shoe store, they look at your feet and they can figure it out.
13¾ inches, dragon heart string. Let's give this one a try.
I had a shoe guy back when I was living in South Dakota that legitimately could bring shoes in exactly this way.
Oh goodness.
Oh shit, yeah, that's what happened when I tried on a bad pair of shoes.
For you. This is proving to be trickier than I had anticipated. How perplexing.
Okay.
Where are you? Perhaps you? There you are.
Oh, is that the good one?
Yes. I think you might be the one. Here. Take it.
I will be scared.
Yeah, after the last few.
Okay.
Oh, we can customize it. Oh, that is so cool. Okay, what can we do to make it pretty? I like this one, I think. It looks kind of like my stick.
Yeah, that looks nice.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna go with this one.
Okay.
What do we have for wood types? I can't remember what the different woods mean, so I'm just gonna pick a wood that I like, because we have opinions on wood. I like...
Curious indeed.
Let's see if they have... Yes, they do. Okay, I want to do cedar because I love the smell of cedar. Like, cedar, like... Yes.
Yeah, I like the smell of cedar too. I actually have a shit ton
How
of cedar.
Intriguing.
You should make me a magic wand out of the cedar.
Yeah, you want a magic wand?
I do.
Okay, I make you a wand.
Ooh, I want a surprisingly swishy wand. Or maybe just regular swishy. I think regular swishy is good. No, 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 it's gotta be swishy. Just regular swishy. Yes, okay. Oh, for the core. Oh, come on. We all know my personality. I have to go with the unicorn.
Totally.
A unicorn hair wand is most reliable and faithful to its owner.
So am I.
Aww.
I am reliable and faithful to my owner.
Yeah?
What do you think? Extraordinary. Another wand, another beginning of a bright and magical future.
Yay!
Now, how did that feel?
Good.
Different. I sensed a sort of surge of some kind.
A match. Your connection seemed particularly powerful. The right wand will learn from you, just as you learn from it.
I'm eager to try it out.
Indeed. Treat it well, and you shall find no more dependable a wand than one with a unicorn hair core. And the bond between you and your wand should only grow stronger. Do not be surprised at your new wand's ability to perceive your intentions, particularly in a moment of need.
Oh, that'll be helpful.
That sounds wonderful, Mr. Ollivander.
I'll let you get to it. Do come and see me again if ever I can be of further assistance.
Huh, cool. All right.
Well, that's everything. Better go and find Natty.
Mm-hmm. Whee! Have to do a somersault every once in a while just to make sure I'm awake, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Do that in real life, too. I'll be running down the street and I'll just go,
hey, Natty. Wait, was that a dog?
I have everything. I see what you meant about not being able to pick a favorite shop.
They're awesome.
We should walk around a bit more. Perhaps today is the day I finally pick one.
What was that? Oh! Why am I attacking it?
What's going on?
Yeah, let the
the grown-ups handle it. Yeah.
I don't know. Why did they think you could take that on? Is that another one?
Oh, shit.
Okay.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Okay, I guess this one we have to fight.
Okay, well, I guess we're gonna take it on.
Oh, God. Oh, wait, why am I trying to repair him? Oh, God.
Do not, please. So,
oh, shit.
Can you lift him up in the air? Or is he too big? Oh, shit.
Oh, there. No, can't lift him.
Oh, no,
Natty! Oh, shit, he's juggling Natty!
Oh, my God. Oh, you can throw him things. That's cool. Okay. Ah!
Woo!
I like it. Do more.
Okay, I'll keep doing that. This seems like a good thing.
Okay, she's shooting him in the ass while you're throwing him barrels.
This seems to be working well. This seems to be an amazing spell.
Well, we'll definitely be popular after this.
Yeah, this is one way to earn your reputation.
We need to make sure he stays that way.
Woo. Oh, shit. Is there more barrels to throw him?
I don't think so.
Ah! Your spell is just tickling him.
Yeah, it's not doing a whole hell of a lot. Okay. I don't see anything.
Okay, I mean, that's fine. You keep shooting at
Natty, are you okay?
Natty's getting her ass kicked. Like, she's getting her ass kicked.
Oh. What does that do? Oh!
That was impressive.
I obliterated him! I obliterated the shit out of him!
Goodness, a second troll. Did you two take on a fully grown troll by yourselves?
I suppose so. Yeah. It's all a bit of a blur, to be honest.
Merlin's beard. Are you all right?
No!
And we were glad to help. I'd say help is a bit of an understatement. Nerve like that. The makings of an aura, if you ask me. If you are unharmed, perhaps the two of you wouldn't mind helping me put a few things back to where they were.
Of course, Officer.
Singer. Officer Singer.
Why do we have to?
And thank you, again.
We gotta clean up too?
Why? We just saved the whole fucking town and now we have to fix it? That doesn't make any sense. That's
I know,
not
right?
Fair.
Hello there. A moment if you would.
I will see what he wants.
Okay. Wait, you're ditching me? You're making me- Oh my God, she's gonna make me clean up the whole shit all by myself? No! Natty! The hell, girl? Okay, fine. I guess I'll just start fixing shit. I gotta do everything around here. It's, you know, let's make the teenager fight the troll and then do major construction around town. That makes sense. Totally.
Lucky they didn't hit me.
I know, because you would have been here all day.
100%. Like, legitimately though, are they gonna pay us to do all this work?
I hope so. We need money and we need a job.
Money. Like, yeah.
And this wasn't our fault.
No, this wasn't our fault at all. The troll did all this.
For Officer Singer to worry about.
Oh, the kitty! Oh, there's a kitty over there?
Yes. He's behind all those boxes.
Kitty? Hi, kitty! Hi! Oh, you're a good girl! Or a boy, I don't know, I can't tell. But you're good and wonderful. Aww. Yes. Okay. Gotta take time to pet the cats.
Okay. Is everything fixed?
I think so.
See? Like nothing happened.
God! Oh. It came back! It followed me! Okay, I guess I'll pet you again. It just the cat appeared.
I didn't know they could do magic too.
It's like the Cheshire Cat, man. He just appears wherever he wants. I guess we must give really good pets.
We were just talking about you.
Yeah, was it good things? Do you have any tea? I'm thirsty.
Hello, sir. I don't believe we've met.
Allow me to introduce myself. Augustus Hill, clothier extraordinaire. I should like to thank you for your remarkable bravery in fighting those trolls, and not to mention your help restoring Hogsmead to its rightful state.
I was happy to help.
Sort of.
Frankly, you deserve an Order of Merlin. But I can offer you something much more useful. I own Gladrag's Wizardware, and among my inventory are some unique items that afford certain protections, as it were. Life-saving protections.
Hmm.
And as I suspect this won't be your last dangerous encounter, I'd like to give you one such set of robes, in thanks for what you did today.
Oh, all right, I guess clothes are good.
Thank you, Mr. Hill. That's very generous of you.
It's the least I can do. Now, let's try this on for size, shall we? Plenty for your perusal today. Take your time.
Okay, I'm guessing this is what he wanted to give me. Everything else is, like, expensive.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Right. What do we have for... Go to the cloaks and robes gear slot. Okay. It looks exactly the same. But thank you. I appreciate the thought.
There's a bunch of, like, pins on his outfit.
What an extraordinary introduction
that
to
Hogsmead. That is
Hogsmead.
So cool.
I would say that we, and you in particular, have earned at least one butterbean.
Yeah, right?
Shall we head to the Three Broomsticks?
Yes.
Sounds like a good
Absolutely.
Idea.
Wonderful. Just down this way, then.
I sell even more battle-worthy items, should you be inclined. You're most welcome to peruse my shop at your leisure.
Maybe later.
Assuming it is not too busy, you might even meet Serona, the owner. She is a charming hostess and a powerful witch.
Oh, really?
Good one to know.
Okay, cool. Uh-oh, what happened? Is it another troll?
We don't have time for more trolls.
Oh, worse, it's a man in a top hat.
Why are we following him?
I don't know.
Oh, it's that guy.
You said you could get to the child when they came to Hogsmead. That all you needed was a distraction.
Oh, shit, they were trying to kill us?
You a distraction.
I just watched a student take down your distraction. Who's this child? What are you not telling me?
All you need to know is that if you cannot get to the child, then you have no value to me.
Let's go.
Who's the child?
Did they see us?
I think that's us.
I don't think so.
What was that goblin doing with Victor Rookwood?
Ranrok is working with Rookwood.
Who's Rookwood again?
The goblin from the Daily Prophet. I knew I'd seen him somewhere.
I think Rookwood is the guy
Quickly,
in the top hat.
Let's get inside the
and Ranrok is the goblin, I think. So basically, if their name starts with R, they're probably bad.
It's a treat to see you, Lord Gok. I shall let you know if I hear anything.
Thank you, Serona.
You be well.
Just, like, slam in.
We just run in, like...
Now, what can I... Oh. There's a face I haven't seen before.
Yeah, I'm new.
It's my first time here.
Welcome. Butterbeer's on me.
Oh, thank you. I'm so glad to get a free
Heard
drink.
About the attack. I shall be looking in on the other shopkeepers and residents shortly. Glad to see you two escaped injury.
Thanks to this one. Single-handedly took down a troll.
You
Is
helped.
That right? Well done.
Thank you.
Thank you for this.
My pleasure. I will say, trolls in Hogsmead. That's never happened before.
Yeah.
That's not right.
Mm-hmm. No.
The only brutes we usually have to deal with are...
Those ones?
No.
How timely.
Was that Lodgok I saw leaving just now? Your clientele's not what it used to be, Serona.
Not to worry, Victor. Once the two of you leave, the caliber of my clientele will greatly improve.
Oh,
would
burn.
You do that if I were you, Theophilus?
Come now. No need for theatrics. I'm only here for this one anyway.
My friend
is enjoying a well-earned butterbeer.
Only want a quick word.
Perhaps you didn't hear me.
Oh!
I said, my friend is busy.
We got friends.
One would think you all had enough bloodshed for one day. Come, Theophilus. The three broomsticks isn't what it used to be. Let's take our galleons elsewhere. Can't drink butterbeer forever.
I don't like you. You're scary. Thank you for saving our ass. We appreciate it.
I like her.
Made an unfortunate enemy.
She's badass. I love
Watch
her.
Your back. Rookwood and Harlow are worse than any troll you might encounter.
Huh.
Trolls, Ranrok, and Rookwood. What are you not telling
I'm
me?
I'm trouble.
I promise to tell you everything. But it's perhaps best I do that later.
Yeah, I think we need to GTFO, honestly.
I think that now might be a good time to head back to the castle.
Yeah, do you have a broomstick? Can we just, like, fly over there and get there quicker? Because I am afraid to walk.
Yeah, I don't want to get kidnapped or murdered by this guy.
Oh my god, it's nighttime. Oh no.
I don't know if it's safer. I really don't. I don't think it is, honestly. Can we leave? Can we go home?
I am certainly glad Serona was there.
Yeah, can she walk us home?
She isn't intimidated by thugs like Rookwood and Harlow.
I want to understand what's going on, and I hope you will tell me. But for the moment, we should return to the castle. Professor Weasley will certainly hear about the troll attack soon if she hasn't already. I don't want her to worry.
I think she's already worried about us, honestly.
Oh, we can fast travel there. Okay. So we won't get kidnapped on the way.
Okay, that's good. I am much too tired to be kidnapped tonight. Yeah. I really cannot deal with anything else. Okay. So we go to our common room. All right, bedtime.
Well, we've had an interesting day, to say the least.
Yeah, I think our first day was really exciting, and now I'm really a little bit nervous about what day two is gonna entail.
I know, apparently we are wanted by Rookwood in this, what's the other?
Rookwood, Ranrok.
Yeah. And we wanted by these bad people, I guess. And then the trolls almost, you know, the trolls attacked us. And I don't know, there's all kinds of stuff going on.
There's a lot going on. All right, well, we'll see you next time. Bye.